Hi, ladies.
Hi.
Oh, what you got?
This is all natural energy drink.
Oh, yeah. Party hard. Okay. And what's with these?
That's the cinnamon flavor one. It's the original.
And then what is it?
It's called hard. It's an all natural energy.
So there's four vitamin B's, which is like 12, 4, 6.
I would suggest trying the green one. So the green one is going to be a Sichuan flavor. That's our original flavor. The orange is our ginger, and the blue is our clove.
Nice. Hello, ladies. Hi, is it okay if I... it's okay, right? Cannolis? Nice.
Fresh.
Wow, look at this, y'all. Look at that.
We make the shells and make the cream.
Really? And what do you make the shells out of?
Which one would you like?
Cannolis. And you make it on the spot?
Yeah.
Oh. How long you been painting?
I started painting in 2005.
2005, wow. That was your first time or?
Yeah, my first paint I still have from 2005. I started drawing in third grade.
Oh, okay. Nice. And where you from?
I'm from Newark, New Jersey.
Newark, New Jersey? Oh, okay. So you're trying to get into the World Boxing Federation?
No, I'm already there.
You're already there?
These are my belts.
Oh, okay. Okay. So what can...
What's his name?
His name is Umar Lewis. Umar Amir Lewis. He's out of Washington, D.C.
And Don King, he's not a boxer, but he was always wherever.
You know what? I didn't know much about boxing either.
Okay.
In fact, I didn't even like boxing.
Oh, really?
No, I thought boxing was the stupidest, dumbest sport ever. I'm like, what kind of sport is getting hit in the face?
Mm.
And then I used to think, like, they had a ref that I thought was dumb. If you hit me, I'm hitting you anywhere I can. Behind the head, below the belt, everything. I'm just trying to hit you.
Oh, okay.
And so I started boxing very late. I started boxing when I was in the Army, when I was 20, 21 years old. Then I only boxed for 4 years before I made it to the Olympics.
Wow.
And what year was that?
88.
Okay, could you let our audience know your full name?
Oh,
Your real name?
My earth name.
Yeah.
My Alfred R. Cole.
Okay.
And your boxing name?
Al Ice Cole.
Al Ice Cole.
Right. Okay. And so when people say, when they hear Ice Cole, they think it's C-O-L-D.
Mm-hmm.
But my real name is C-O-L-E.
Okay.
So they think it's...
Like Nat King Cole.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Okay.
I can't say
Nat
nothing
King
like
Cole. So who have you fought?
Well, I was a dominant world champ. I was from 92 to 98.
Okay.
That's when
what class?
Cruiserweight. It's really junior heavyweight.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people don't know. Now it's anything up under 200.
Okay.
You know, which is like junior heavyweight, but... Heavyweights at the time was so popular with like Holyfield, Mike Tyson, Ray Mercer, Riddick Bowe, all the Lennox Lewis.
Mm-hmm.
And so they overshadowed all the weight classes.
Okay.
And so, and I was like, I was the dominant title, but the big guys, everybody know the big guys, and that was the heavyweight. Actually, Holyfield was the only cruiserweight that was really known. He moved up to heavyweight.
Oh, okay.
So what year did you retire?
Oh, well, I'll fight tomorrow if they let me.
Oh, so you didn't retire. You haven't retired?
Yeah, I retired about 5-6 years ago.
Okay.
So
what have you been doing?
Well, right now, praise God, I've been blessed that I've trained some people to fight, but I've been blessed right now. I try to catapult my success to Hollywood.
Mm.
So now,
you do look like a movie star.
So you was getting into acting?
Yeah, now I try to act like I can fight.
Oh, you try? Okay.
One of the biggest movies I did was the Ali movie.
Okay.
With Will Smith.
Oh, okay.
One of the fighters in the movie.
Oh.
I helped train with Will Smith.
Okay.
And so my name is Ernie Terrell in the movie. So I'm the guy that, I don't know if y'all know Muhammad Ali's real name. What was his birth name?
Oh, Cassius Clay.
Okay. So like today's generation, they don't know it. Mm-hmm. Like they just know it's Ali, like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Yeah.
Mm. Knowing the younger kids, they don't know.
Yeah, we don't know. We right. only know Ali or Muhammad, if we hear that sometime. Mm-hmm. We only know Tyson. Now Holyfield.
Right.
Some of us know Holyfield, but a lot of us didn't know about all the other boxers, or you don't know. Maybe you're just not into it.
Right, no, you really, it's like back then with the black power, the black self-righteousness and black movement back then, Ali was a great voice for the people.
Mm-hmm.
And so back then boxing was much more popular, and then even as the years go by, they have a real true heavyweight, like they're doing a movie that's coming out with, I don't know, y'all probably never heard the name of Jack Johnson.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. They about to do a movie like of a black man. It was very hard for a black man to be the heavyweight
Didn't
world champion.
Did they characterize that in The Great White Hope, Jack Johnson?
Yeah, that's why they made the movie. Mm-hmm. That's why they have The Great White Hope. Because this big, strong black
dominated
he was the world. And then when everybody is what's so racist and prejudiced, you can't have the baddest man on the planet being a black guy.
Right. Okay.
Right.
They wasn't ready for that.
No, so that's why they had the Great White Hope. Mm-hmm.
So Ice Cold, I'm curious, how many fights have you won? Have you defeated?
Actually, my record, I don't even remember. I'm like 30, maybe about 36 and 14.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, when I started losing, my record was like 28 and 1.
Mm-hmm.
And I advanced by one loss. Before my mother died.
Okay.
Once my mother died, I lost like 10, 12 fights in a row.
Was she your inspiration?
My mother was very encouraging to do something. It's just like, after my mother died, I got very lackadaisical. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't push myself, I wouldn't do stuff. Then I had a couple of my brothers die, and I was just, didn't realize till years later, I was more in a depressed state.
Okay.
But I wasn't getting up in the morning and running.
Okay.
And I moved up to heavyweight and I wouldn't even run late. So in my other weight class, you got to run and make weight. You got to keep your weight down.
Yes,
well, you're looking
yes.
very dapper right thank now. You, so you learned some things.
It's a life experience. You know, it was really some experience because I had so many people die. That like in 3 years, I almost had like 10 deaths. And so I was trying to figure out as a big, strong black man, I could do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just going through the motions and not really focused.
Yes.
And I just started losing fights and didn't really care.
What would you tell any boxer that's up and coming boxer right now? What would you to encourage them to do that to help them through the become a champion?
Have another career.
Have another career?
Yeah, have another career. I'm the first American fighter to ever fight in Moscow.
Wow, congratulations.
Yeah, I'm the first world title championship ever held in Moscow.
Wow.
And one of my last fight, I was 46 and the guy was 26 and I beat him.
Wow, is it okay to ask you how old are you now?
I'm there.
Well, Dad, you look good.
No, I'm 53.
46?
Okay.
Wow.
I'm 53.
Well,
okay.
May God continue.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're going to be here a long time looking young.
Yeah, I do boxing. I like living, so I want to take good.
Okay.
God only gave us one body. You got another body hanging up in the closet, you know, then you might say, God only gave you one body. If you don't take care of this body, what will you take care of?
No, yes. Nothing. Mm-hmm. Nothing, because you won't be able to be here.
Right, exactly.
Yep. Yeah. Thank you so much for that interview.
God
thank you.
Y'all. Thank y'all very much.
Yes.
I want to see this, because I got to learn to spell the right Safari. So you got to spell
Sakari.
It.
Sakari. It's Sukari. Raphael, RAPHAEL. You can Google me.
China.
You got Coco China, dog.
C-O-C-H-Y-N-N-A. And you can call me the doll, because that's what I feel.
That's great,
because
I would have thought, John, you had two N's.
That's why we have to spell it.
Yes. Yes.
All right. Thank you. God bless y'all. Watch this show.
Okay.
Evening at the Atlantic City Boxing Hall of Fame with the legendary Michael Spinks. And Mr. Spinks is one of the inductees for 2017. How are you, Mr. Spinks?
I'm doing fine.
Okay. Well, what does this induction and being a Hall of Famer mean to you?
You know, I didn't understand it a little while back, but I mean, it means a lot. It means a lot. It means that I'll be etched in stone for the rest of, even after my life.
And after life. Right. So, you know, that's creating a legacy.
Yes.
So,
yes. Trying, but I was talking to myself. That's what you get for trying to pull out. I said, all right, I'm going in. And so, my coach, the one that taught me how to fight way back in St. Louis, he always said, he don't want us walking out of the ring a loser. He said, if you lose, they better be carrying you out on a stretcher.
Okay.
So.
But shout out to St.
That was,
Louis.
That was the mentality. That was the mentality that we had. And so, you come to die.
Yeah.
You come to die. You don't look forward to dying, but you're going to fight like hell so that you kill somebody else instead of you getting killed.
Okay. Yeah. And in general, what do you feel about this chosen profession, being a professional boxer?
Well, it was fun for a while. But the pros aren't fun. Mm-hmm. Amateurs, you have a lot of fun. But as a pro, I mean, it's like life or death, mm-hmm. you know, because you got smaller gloves. I mean, and you really fighting for your life in there. Mm-hmm. But it's a sport, so I kept the sportsman type of mind.
Okay.
And I didn't want to hurt nobody. I didn't want to get hurt. But I said, well, you know, better them than me.
Okay. What is one of your most memorable fights that you have?
Well, when I became my light heavyweight matches, when I fought for the heavyweight championship.
Okay. And who was that you fought?
I fought Larry Holmes for the heavyweight championship.
Mm-hmm. And what year was that?
That was in 1985. And he was undefeated at the time. And I also was undefeated. But he was a bigger man. But I got matched up with him. So I just, you know, as time went on, when I got to the fight site, it really started working on me. You know, wondering if I'm going to lose, if I'm going to win, or how am I going to win? Am I going to get off the canvas to win? How am I going to win? How am I going to beat this guy? So I just, you know, I had a pep talk with myself. Go to sleep, man. You haven't fought the fight yet. You haven't lost, mm-hmm. so stop thinking you're going to lose and just do what you're good at. Do mm-hmm. what you're best at.
What does it feel like to be a winner?
Oh,
champion.
It's a great feeling. It's a great feeling, especially as a sportsman. Mm-hmm. It's kind of hard to beat. It's kind of hard to beat that feeling mm-hmm. when you win, especially mm-hmm. if you win a big prize like the heavyweight championship. That's like the most coveted prize in all sports. I mean, to be, because you looked upon to be able to beat any man on earth, you know, mm-hmm. as a heavyweight.
As
so,
a heavyweight.
Yeah, so I said, if I do win, guess who I told my people, my corner man, and I said, guess who I become when I win the fight? They said, well, who? I said, Superman.
Okay.
Because Superman is looked upon to be able to beat any man on earth.
That's right.
He's a big man, so anyway.
Unless you get hit with kryptonite.
Yes, get hit with kryptonite. Okay. You got to fight that.
But since that didn't happen, and you are here today being an inductee, which the ceremony will be tomorrow, and you're coming, and everything that has led up to this point, what do you want to share with the young boxers of today? How do you feel about the sport today?
Well, it's a lack of talent. Lack mm-hmm. of talent. And you don't have a lot of good guys that train or teach good teachers mm-hmm. in boxing. And I thank God that the guy that taught me how to fight, he was a school teacher. So he had ways of teaching that were great. And he gave everybody sort of kind of a different style of fight boxing. Mm-hmm. everybody that he had trained fought different, but in the same way, in a sense, but we all had our own styles.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So that was the blessing in having a coach that was a teacher.
That's beautiful.
And he did teach.
Okay.
He did teach.
So being surrounded by the right people, you would say, that's
a
good...
Yes, for sure. Somebody that's very versed in teaching you just how to do it. Mm-hmm. I had ways because I wouldn't look when we got in the center of the range and square off or the ref with tells him come to the center of the ring. I would look at my opponent, but then I would drop my head and look around at the ground and I was giving him an impression that I was afraid. Mm.
And they playing possum.
Yeah, I played possum. And what they would do, they would come on with the come on once the fight started, and that was the only way I was able to maybe knock him down. And I think in a tournament that I won in 1974, I played that game where I'm looking down the ground and acting like I'm afraid, and everybody, I fought five times, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday, and every fight that I had, the five fights, I knocked everybody down the first round with that game I played.
Was there every time that you thought you won and then the decision went against you?
Yeah, yeah. It was one guy, he was a favorite. He was in the Air Force. And another guy, it was a white boy. And I think he was favored because he was in his hometown in Knoxville, Tennessee. And I was sure I beat him, but they gave it to him, and they gave it to the guys I knocked down. I knocked them down about three times.
And they still gave it to him.
They still gave it to him. You know, and that hurt. It hurt when you win. When you really win, and they rob you. So it was just leave a bitter taste in your mouth.
Right.
For the sport, because I'm like, I can't win. You get to thinking bad things about the sport and how it's rigged to favor certain boxes.
Well, we have Jackie Love sitting right next to you.
All right.
And I'm the Coco China doll. And we're here to nominate you for the Men of Excellence Awards. It's happening on December 16th. 2017 in Brooklyn. So we're extending this invitation to be part of the Men of Excellence because we feel you are a man of excellence.
Oh, man. Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
USBO super middleweight champion.
Okay.
Right now I'm ranked number 8 right now in our country. 23-1, 12 knockouts. I'm actually from Jersey.
Okay.
6'4 Southpaw. They consider me right now the most dangerous Southpaw in boxing.
Oh, so you're getting close to Tyson, you saying?
Hey, I mean, like, listen, I don't run from nothing.
Okay,
you know what I mean?
I'm
always prepared. But I'm a different type of fighter.
Okay.
I didn't start boxing until I was 24. I'm 34 years old now, so I'm a young 34.
Yes.
And I'm ruining the dreams of other fighters been fighting their whole life. You know what I mean? They've been fighting since they were kids.
Wow.
And I should be learning something from them to where now they're taking the page out of my book.
Wow.
So I say that boxing chose me.
Yes.
And I'm out to get whatever God has for me.
Yes.
And right now, I mean, it's just everything is working well. I was just in the movie Creed.
Oh, you were in Creed.
I was also in Bad Boxer.
Okay.
So it seems like my life is going into the movie industry as well. I'm marketing.
That's great. That's great. And you look like you fit every role.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, there's a saying, jack of all trades, master of none. I think that's just a myth. Because if you know how to do it, you can master it.
Yeah.
No matter how much crafts you have. You know, and I want to congratulate you. You're young and 12 knockouts. That's great. So what, you started at 24. So did you ever think you was going to become a boxer?
That's funny. No, I didn't. It's like as a kid, I had no interest in boxing.
Mm-hmm.
But if I got into a street fight, I was boxing.
Okay, okay.
Before I was boxing, I was actually singing. So from singing to boxing, it's like a...
Wow.
It's totally
can I ask you what month is your birthday?
June 9th.
Okay. Very talented. You're very talented. And that's good to hear. Singing. You were singing before boxing. And you know what's so funny? I've always wanted to be a boxer. But I sing. And I love Muhammad Ali's daughter. I wanted to be just like her. I wanted to do things like she's doing. But we can't be everything we want to be. But you never know. It's never too late.
Well, you know what I do is I just take every talent that God gave me,
mm-hmm.
and I use it for my own. That's what I do. And one thing that I would always tell the younger generation
is
never bank on just one thing. You know what I mean? Like boxing is a very small window.
Mm-hmm.
A very small window. So therefore what I'm saying is like you gotta be able to branch off.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so with my boxing, I have modeling, I have singing, I own 4 businesses,
mm-hmm.
I have a college degree,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? So if boxing gave me my name, take it to the bank, and for short, it's the bank,
mm-hmm.
but what I did was I took everything inside of me to make my brand so much bigger.
Mm.
So if boxing went away tomorrow, I'm still the bank.
That's what's up.
I just start touching into other avenues that I place in my life.
So what do you want to tell our youngsters out here?
Learn how to build alone. You know what I mean?
What do you mean by that?
It's so easy to run with a crowd. And I mean, it's cool to have friends. It's good to have friends. But learn how to build who you are as an individual. Be an individual. Don't be a part of a group.
That's right.
What I mean is, like, you know, you can go play basketball with 6-7 people. But at the end of that day, everybody go their own way. Which means everybody has their own path.
Yes.
Figure out your purpose. Figure out what you want to do in life. And stay on the course. Because 9 out of 10 times, as you grow up, those same people are not going to be there anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So learn who you are as an individual. Be an individual. Be a leader.
Yes, yes.
Don't be a follower. Don't be known for, oh, that guy in the group.
Yes.
Be known for being that individual.
Tell us your name again.
Derek Webster. Derek, take it to the bank, Webster.
Derek, take it to the bank, Webster. That sounds beautiful. Where can everybody check you out at?
They can find me on Facebook, which is just Derek Webster. Same thing as mm-hmm. Instagram. Same thing as Twitter, but I don't really, you know,
mm-hmm.
I'm not really the social media dude.
Mm-hmm.
But you can find me on
mm-hmm.
Facebook I'm mainly on.
Mm-hmm.
I answer all messages. I talk back to my fans, talk back to my support.
Mm-hmm.
So Derek Webster, Derrick Webster.
Okay, so I hope to see you and doing some more. Have you traveled throughout the country?
Yeah, I've been in China, Germany, you know, I see a lot of different states.
Okay.
Right now, you know, I'm moving up the ranks with Down in Promotions.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Ms. Down in Promotions, and she's breaking into the industry, doing a lot of different things on a greater level.
Okay.
Than a lot of other people. Actually, my first fight with her, I won a title.
Wow.
So she made me a two-time champion in 1 year.
Wow, beautiful.
You know,
so she gets the boxes out there. She works
with
boxes.
She gets the job done.
Yes.
She gets the job done. And,
yes.
And a lot of times people close the door on new beginners.
Yes.
But sometimes you can't take away from what's already there.
That's right.
You know what I mean? And she already has the fun. She already has it. She has the goal. She has the vision.
Mm-hmm.
And when you follow your own vision, can't nobody shake that up.
That's right. You know what I mean? Thank you so much, Derek. Nice meeting you. Thank you for this interview, because this is history for me.
This is CCN FFM Magazine, which is CCN Network and CMB Network. We were here covering the red carpet, doing interviews. We had a wonderful time at the Fan Fight Experience, which we had all of the inductees. They were there signing autographs.